This is the Asus ZenBook Pro Duo. It's got a dual 4K display setup, comes with a stylus, it has some decent ground clearance to allow for air inflow, and it's fast. Hey guys, it's Fisar here, and in this video I'll be talking about this dual screen laptop, the Asus ZenBook Pro Duo. The ZenBook Pro Duo was launched in September of 2019, just a little over 10 months from now, and I've had it in my hands for some weeks, and you know, I've been testing it out. Asus released two versions of this product, the ZenBook Duo, which is a 14-inch smaller version with lesser specs, and this ZenBook Pro Duo. The difference between both of them is the Pro in the name of this one, and this is 15.6 inches. It's the one we have in this video. I'll share my thoughts about this laptop, and I also have my timestamps in the description of this video, so you can always skip ahead to different sections of this video that you want quick information about, that you're quickly concerned about. Without further ado, let's get to the video. Before I move on, guys, I'd love it if you could hit the subscribe button and click the bell icon beside it so you'll be notified when we post a new video. That being said, we'll get right into this amazingness of a laptop beside me here. Should you buy this, you're going to be getting two boxes: the main box that houses your computer, the wrist pad for resting your wrists, the stylus, and paperwork. In the second box is just the power brick. I'll start off with the display in my usual fashion, and guys, this is a dual 4K display. For technical specifications, the top display resolution is set at 3840 by 2160. It's 15.6 inches OLED 4K, 100% DC IP3, and it's touchscreen with thin enough bezels, 5.5 millimeters thin, and 89% screen to body ratio. Of course, if you don't mind the chin below, and you know, we know it's there for a reason, which is the secondary display. And speaking of the secondary display, that too is also a 4K display. The ScreenPad Plus, as Asus calls it, is 14 inches, 3840 by 1100 as far as the screen resolution. And you know, it's got the four finger smart gesture support. While the smaller option, the smaller, more portable option of this laptop, also with a dual screen, isn't 4K, it's a worthy option. The ZenBook Pro Duo right now, this laptop, at the time of this recording, is priced at $2,350 or 1 million naira for the Core i7 version with 16 gigs of RAM. The Core i9 version, the one I have here with 32 gigs of RAM, is $2,999 or $3,000. Who are we kidding? That roughly translates to 1.4 million naira approximately. Wow, that's the version I have here. I'll leave relevant links to buy or other alternatives in the description below, guys, so you know, support the channel. However, the official statement according to Asus in Nigeria is that Asus is planning to make the device available in Nigeria through their partner stores from 1,115,500 naira and not 1.4 million, which would save you a lot of money. Bring out your checkbooks, bring out your wallet, bring out your banking apps. Why should you buy this? I've talked about the display a bit, and you know, the second display, the ScreenPad Plus, isn't just there for a gimmick, it does serve a real purpose. The secondary display serves as an actual second screen and not just like a touch bar, which is something we've seen on something like MacBooks. It's not a second screen on the MacBooks, it doesn't really have a ton of features if we're being honest. This creates room for a couple of things because of the aspect ratio of this secondary display. It's sort of a 2x1 display, so yes, if anything, it's almost as good as having an external monitor, I guess. And Windows 3 is like an external display. It doesn't just stop there. I'm a designer, I'm a video editor, I'm someone who loves music, I love sound, and I'm sure I'm not alone. A typical use case for this computer would be me using Photoshop to edit assets while I have control of my panel, my history, my layers, and everything else in the secondary screen, and I have my main design in focus on the main screen. I can easily go to the taskbar, open up Spotify, change music I'm listening to while I'm editing, and then swipe right to my preset Premiere Pro screens, where I have my second screen. I have the bins right there, I have my controls, my whole timeline in the secondary screen, and my main edit in the main screen. Is just cool. You can switch between both screens, between screens, if that makes sense. And I like how it scales apps, although it can be a bit tiny to the text and, you know, a bit not so great on the eyes if you don't like to read tiny texts. One thing to note is that this top display is reflective, or a glossy panel is OLED, while the bottom display is a matte finish, and light affects them differently. If you are a reader, if you're someone who reads a lot or writes a lot or does reference materials, you can use this one of three ways, although your creativity will definitely open more doors for you. There's a normal desktop mode with the file opened up, which we are used to, you know, the top half. There's the scaled up version where we have the app flowing from the top to the bottom second screen, and then there's the one where it's just in the second screen part plus of this computer. For good measure, the screen part plus has some toggles to the right where you can perform some simple functions. Here you can do simple things like increase the brightness of the secondary screen. You have group task or task group, which gives you the option to open up 5 apps at once, 3 at the bottom, 2 in the main screen. There's also a switch that changes what's on the bottom screen to the top and brings what's on the top to the bottom. It's called the task swap switch. The multitasking button to switch between apps, and lastly, the keyboard lock, which does exactly what it says it does, locks your keyboard. Keep in mind that task swap button is also around the power button area. There's also a button for turning off the screen part plus 2, and then there's this mysterious button. It's called the turbo fan button. This increases the fan speed by 10% to help reduce overall temperature if you notice your laptop is getting a little too warm. This will help your CPU's performance a lot, and when I tested it out, it wasn't that loud. Also guys, if you've gotten this far into this video and you're finding it really useful, I'll appreciate it if you could please give this video a thumbs up and let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Alright, when you open up the laptop, a bunch of things are happening at once. First off, the Ergo Lift hinge is lifting the laptop's base off of the table, allowing it to breathe. This tilts the keyboard upwards towards your face, allowing for a more ergonomic typing position, which is where it gets its name, Ergo Lift, from. Included in the box of the Asus ZenBook Pro Duo and the ZenBook Duo is this wrist rest pad, which helps for ergonomics. It looks like it's made out of some soft touch leather material where your hands rest on, and there's plastic on the back. This is because the keyboard has been brought downwards to the bottom of the laptop, and it's certainly not conventional for most laptops. While this isn't really a major inconvenience, the wrist rest does help a bunch with resting your hands and typing on this device. Now, I sort of wish every laptop had a wrist rest. At first, I thought the light that came out from the center of the bottom was just for decoration, but it actually works and it changes colors when you voice commands at it, specifically for Alexa and Cortana. This laptop weighs 2.5 kg or 5.51 pounds, and it's 2.4 centimeters thick, or less than an inch in height. When it comes to ports and I/O, on the right side from left to right, we have the power or charging indicator, the Thunderbolt 3 USB-C port, headphone jack, fan, and the Gen 2 USB 3.1. On the left side, you have the DC in port for a power supply, HDMI port, and another Gen 2 USB 3.1 port, and more fans, of course. I like the keyboard travel on here. It's 1.4 millimeters of travel, and it's the chiclet style design featuring wide keys that are separated. And it's of course backlit for typing at night or in dark. Very, very welcome. There are hotkeys that I spoke about earlier, and for the trackpad, while I thought it was not as large, I mean, who am I kidding? You have dual 4K touchscreens on here. However, I like big trackpads, but this did the job. This trackpad is different. It's the latest version of Asus's number pad, which lets you press and hold this icon to bring up an actual number pad. So when you see it, or when you say text field, it would actually work, and you can even scroll while it's on. It's also LED illuminated, and you have the option of dimming it right there on the touchpad. Audio hardware on here is certified Harman Kardon, tuned by experts. It sounds really nice. I'm a big music guy. I listen to music on this a lot, and it was good. Processor wise, as I mentioned, we've got two options. The Core i7 option, 2.6 GHz with turbo boost up to 4.5 GHz, and the Core i9 version, this one with 2.4 GHz base, can be turbo boosted up to 5 GHz. There's the 8, 16, and 32 gigabyte RAM option for this guy, and then there's 256 gigs, 512 gigs, and 1 terabyte of SSD. This is a very, very fast computer. As if that wasn't enough, Asus gives you a dedicated graphics processor on here, the NVIDIA's GeForce RTX 2060 with a video memory or VRAM of 6 gigabytes, and I thought it was really worth it. 1.4 million naira. This is the spec'd out version that we have here, and you know, that's not even adding shipping. The good thing for Premiere Pro users now is that Adobe now supports rendering, or at least enhances the rendering with graphics cards, you know, from AMD and Nvidia, and it looks promising. It's actually getting a lot of speed. Other cool features, of course, are the infrared Windows Hello Face scanner that works to unlock your laptop. This also works in the dark, and it's all the more useful. We also get an active stylus in the box with two buttons to the side that works on both screens. I didn't really see a documentation on how to charge it, but it does seem to work like you don't have to charge it. I also wish there was a way to hang it around the laptop, or maybe clipping or some magnets, but you know, I just have to hold it. Yeah. The device's battery life was pretty okay during my use. Using it for my day-to-day tasks, you know, not much of gaming on here. This is a 60 FPS display for those who are curious. Just experiencing this computer, I had like 4 hours of frequent use, of frequent heavy use, and I felt it was just good enough. I'm not keeping this device. Asus loaned it to me for this particular review, but it was really a great experience using this. Like, it's the same price as my 2017 MacBook Pro, but this is much more feature packed. It's way better value for money. Would I recommend this? Yes, it's pretty much one of the very standout laptops out there in the market right now. And as if Asus hasn't even done something great with dual displays on here, they've also outdone themselves with the new Asus Zephyrus Duo, which takes all of the things that makes this guy great and takes it a step further. It lifts the secondary screen up so it's more diagonal and it's pointing towards your face. It's just dope. That's pretty much it, guys. Those are my thoughts about this laptop. Let me know yours. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. If you have any questions, do let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, do give it a thumbs up. If you found this video useful, please hit the subscribe button and the bell icon beside it so you'll be the first to know when I post a new video. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll talk to you guys in the very next video. Wrist rest. Wow.